going to be talking about the bronze whaler, aka Carcharhinus brachyurus. There we go, got it eventually. Otherwise known as a copper shark, but most commonly known as a bronzy down in the Cape. They mature at about 2 meters for the males and about 2.4 about for the females. So it's quite a large shark. You get them all the way down from False Bay up north, not really much north of Durban. And you also get them in places like New Zealand and Australia. They reach over 3 meters in length and well over 200 kilos, but you're normally going to catch them around about the 100 kilogram mark if you're lucky. Most of the smaller guys are about 50. They're very common in the Natal coast when the sardine run comes up. They follow the sardines all the way up, and that's normally when we catch our bigger versions up on this side. Down in the Cape, pretty much there all year round, but definitely more of a summer species. You're going to be targeting them with big fleshy baits, normally either yellowtail flat or down there a big sada head, something like that. And during the sardine run, you can use a bunch of sardines on a single hook or something like that, watching where they are and then throwing to the fish. They get their name from the overall coloration of the fish. It is a bronzy, coppery color on the back with a very white stomach. A short, stubby-ish head, but not as short as a Zambi, a little bit longer. And they look very, very similar to a gray shark, except between the two dorsal fins, there's no ridge that runs along the back, so it's actually smooth. That's the easiest way to tell the difference. Unlike a lot of other sharks, they have very large litters, so 13 to 20 pups, and these pups are born at about 60 to 70 centimeters, so fairly small fish, but they do grow up quite quickly. For bronzies, if you're specifically targeting them, for our Natal anglers, you're generally going to be targeting them in the Transkei. We don't really actively target them here, only on the lower south coast. So you're looking Transkei and then in the Cape region. So for me, I'd say full metal jacket, 12-0 or 10-0 circle, depending on your preference. If you're going to be sliding, the 12-0 circle would be a better option. If you're going to be throwing, 10-0 circle would be a better option. Full metal jacket, 150-pound, 200-pound, thereabouts. And for your braid, I'd say 50-pound mainline, 200-pound or 180-pound braid leader should be perfect for that. And something, a very good strong reel with a lot of drag capacity, or a lot of drag. And a rod looking at about, the guys down in the Cape like a longer rod to get a better throw, so 15 foot. Up here, you're looking 14, 6, 15 foot thereabouts. Something nice and long, you can put a bait out into the deep water where the sharks are. In terms of your main target areas, Namibia is probably, if you want to have a go-to bronzy location, Namibia would be your best bet. It's the most targeted inedible species there, and there you don't actually have to cast very far to get them often. They come right into the shore break. That sort of culture around the targeting the Zambezi, the bronze whalers there, has now filtered through. False Bay, the anticipated bronzy run, if you want to call it that, in summer, is much looked forward to. Then sort of targeting lessons as you go up into the Southern Cape, Eastern Cape. Most of your big deep water spots are going to hold bronzies. Transkei, very good spot for them as well. In terms of fighting, the fish in the Transkei seem to be supercharged. The fights tend to last a lot longer, but in general terms, it's a very strong fish, very hard fighting fish. They've got a big fuel tank, so they're not going to run out of steam very quickly. They have been known to jump on occasion, so don't be worried when your blackfin turns into a bronze whaler when it comes to the beach. But yeah, brilliant fish to target, lovely fish to catch, and very strong. In terms of targeting and tackle, when I'm throwing a bait, 10-0 circle hook, it's perfect for a very, very big bait. Still proud enough to be able to hook the fish and set into the jaw. If it comes to sliding a bait, I'm wanting to get a little bit extra distance maybe, I'm going to slide using a single 12-0 circle hook. That's going to be perfect for a very, very large bait if I do need to get it out a little bit further. In terms of reels, what I'd use is the 8000 Saltist. As we mentioned in many of the other videos, nice handle to grip. Extremely powerful drag, very, very smooth. Onto that, 50-pound J-braid. It's going to take about 800-850 meters of that. And on top of that, 200 pound braid leader, because you need that extra abrasion resistance when you're fishing with the FMJ, especially in a place like the Transcar. In terms of rods, the new 15 foot Elite is a phenomenal rod, and it's got plenty of backbone. It'll be able to cast very far, and you'll be able to pull your ass off on any fish that you want.